did. For your eyes only.
For your eyes.
For your eyes only.
For your eyes only.
For your eyes. For your eyes only. Hey.
What's good, y'all? It's Curtis J. McDaniel. Y'all may know, also know me as Curtis Mac from my Instagram. I just thought I'd come in and let y'all know what's up in my life, what God's been doing in my heart, and what I've been meditating on in this season, on how God's just remaking my mind and really just giving me a new perspective on who I am and also letting me learn more about Him. So I pray that this can be an encouragement to you guys. I'm in a place that I learned a lot from in my life growing up, and I pray that this can be an encouragement to you guys and that you guys can be blessed. Mac out.
Like I ain't the one who put them J's on the feet. Like I ain't out in the field like that. I might be low for the moment, but I will bounce back despite the charges. Back to the wall, I fight regardless, screaming the law. My life is lawless, that's what you call it. Ain't gotta be no psychic to see this is like the farthest thing from heaven. This is hell and I don't mean that hyperbolic.
You
get too much for me to take, and I break, play this tape for my daughter and let her know my life is on it. Let her know my life is on it.
For your eyes
only.
For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes,
probably grown now.
So my pastor was telling me about, as believers, how we struggle and we wrestle with four voices. The first voice that he was telling me about is called the outer voice. That's the satanic voice that tells us, go commit suicide. Go back to watching pornography. That's the voice that tells us give up on life because of where we're from. And then there's another voice, and it's called the outside voice. That's the outside voice of our critics, of our haters, if you could say. The people that tell us we can never be anything because of where we're from, because of what our education is, because of what our socioeconomic status is. We can't be anything. Maybe it's an ex-girlfriend. Maybe it's your mother or your father. Maybe it's a family member. I don't know who it is, but it's just your critic. And then there's another voice, and that's called the inside voice. That's your voice. That's the voice that tells yourself that you don't love yourself, that you can never be anything. It's the voice that tells you because of who you are in the past and because of your past sins, you can never do anything great. But then there's another voice, and that's called the inner voice. And that's the voice of God. That's the voice that tells you that God will not slack on us to fulfill His promises, that He will never leave nor forsake us. That's what the Word of God says. That's the voice that gives us motivation and encourages on a daily basis to get back and to be excellent in everything that we do for His glory. That's the voice that allows us, Lord, the freedom to be creative and create and take an abandoned warehouse like this and create it into something like this. God takes broken vessels and makes them new.
Do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand?